is that there are physical adaptations more important than color, which made a great deal of aggression within this group. A lot of it was due to adaptation and evolution within a glacial environment. Adaptation and evolution within a glacial environment. Within a glacial environment. Within a glacial environment. White people like myself look at themselves in what I consider to be an objective biological mirror, something we have not done because we've written a lot of history, mythologized a lot of history, and have seen it in terms of our own self-image, not the way other people see it. The white race is simply a fact which really all anthropologists agree with, show more differences between men and women than other races. In other words, it's called sexual dimorphism. And that's one characteristic of the Caucasians, is that they have a higher degree of sexual dimorphism than any other race, however many you want to choose to exist. Here's what I would do. I'd try to make myself as independent of the white infrastructure as possible. I would actively oppose it. That's about the only thing you think you can do. Now, I believe that there's difficulties here, and there's also some misapprehensions here, but we haven't had a chance to get into those yet. But I believe that basically speaking, this Caucasian group, and especially the ones from the Middle East, are either going to try to control this world or destroy it. And I think they'd rather destroy it if they can't control it. The essence of this, though, is a curse in the Talmud against black people with their shamefully, black male, with their shamefully large sex organs. And that this is in the Talmud. And this is a font of, because the Jewish tradition is really the font of the Judeo-Christian tradition, and therefore the religion of most white people, this sexual thing is at the very foundation of these religions from the Middle East. And by that I would include Judaism and Islam and all their offshoots, like Judeo-Christianity, the various flavors of Christianity, the various flavors of Judaism, but that's the basis of it. That's how the culture, this white supremacist culture, defined itself by these religions. The point of it is back in biblical times with Jesus, there's quite a bit of evidence that Jesus would have been called, he would have been called a black by some of my former colleagues in the South. But all that was changed to make him a nice white savior. But the fact of the matter is, the first Statue of Liberty, of course, was donated by the French people. And the first Statue of Liberty had nothing to do with liberty in terms of just, you know, liberty as the way we have it now. It was specifically that statue was the liberation of the black slaves. That's what the French gave us that statue for. And the original statue, the Statue of Liberty, is at the French Cultural Center in New York City. The Americans wouldn't accept it until the girl, the Statue of Liberty, was properly Caucasian and properly white, and liberty was an abstract concept. But the first one was a black woman, nude, breaking the shackles of slavery. The black Africans adopted, to some degree, a white Middle Eastern religions, and how they can fight us by using our own religion and being propagandized and infiltrated by it, it beats me. I don't think they can do it, and I think it's an insidious development. Now, I understand now in Africa there is a movement to revive traditional African religions, and I think it's a good idea.
That incarnated here was the souls of those beings that had to basically learn how to who had to pay for their karmic debt for what they did to everybody. But when they incarnated the vessels that they incarnated in were no longer housed melanin. You see what I'm saying? So in essence, they incarnated into melaninless bodies. Or bodies with no melanin, which then, when they incarnated into these souls, into these bodies, and basically woke up and then had no melanin, they basically were savage. You see what I'm saying? When we look at Caucasian people, what we're looking at is an antimatter version of ourselves. We're looking at the version of ourselves without the properties of creation that created us.